Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to another Criterium race breakdown. This is the Sky Express Livermore Criterium, a classic four-corner crit. We had some serious crosswinds. If you look on the little mini-map there, the blue arrows, we'll talk more about that later. Team Mike's Bikes, we had six of us, and who was the competition? Let's see, we had my former team, Tayrun Elite, guys in the pink jerseys, they had five or so, and then I'd say the other big team to look out for was the Ride Bikes Bro team, and they are in the black, blue, and pink jerseys. So team strategy coming into this race. I'm going to keep this as simple as possible. We were pretty confident in our chances with a field sprint. So that was the first priority. But that doesn't mean we're just going to rule out a breakaway. It just had to have the right composition of riders and teams. So for that reason, we established roles on our six-man squad for this race. Chris and Dylan covered early moves. Miles and Brennan covered mid to late race moves. And this allowed Sam and I to sit back and chill for at least the first half of the race. And as a protected sprinters, we were very selective and would only commit energy to a breakaway if it had that perfect composition of riders and teams. Otherwise, we were just going to sit in the draft, conserve energy, and wait for the finish, wait for the lead out. Yeah, teamwork's pretty awesome, isn't it? So with that said, let's just get into the footage. And I have fast-forwarded right up to the end here. We are 5.5 kilometers to go. We are four laps to go, and it's time to get together at the front. The team has done a fantastic job up until this point to be represented in every move off the front, but none of them had that magical composition of riders and teams. So now it's all together for a field sprint. Here we go. The first thing I have to do is get organized at the front as a team. So that's what I'm doing right now. You see, we're all coming together on the front, and the order here is very specific. This is intentional. We have Chris, Dylan, and Brennan right on the front, rotating turns to keep it fast, while Miles, Sam, and myself are at the back, just saving energy for when it gets really fast with one lap to go. So how fast are we going right now? Well, we're going fast enough so that nobody can successfully attack over the top of us, and also nobody can take control of the race, but we don't want to go any faster than that, because we don't want to just burn through our guys and start dropping riders prematurely. Otherwise, Sam and me, her, the protected sprinters, are going to be exposed. So we will keep this speed, and we will slowly ramp up the speed up until about one lap to go, at which point we'll really start going fast as teammates start taking their last pulls, and if we time it perfectly, Sam and I will be hitting the front with about 200 meters to go. So why would Team Mike's Bikes drop off both of their sprinters, Sam and I, at 200 meters to go? That doesn't make a whole lot of sense, right? Well, in this case, we had a full six-rider lead out. We had full control of this race in the closing laps, so what we established was a sweeper, and that's my role. My role's a bit different in this race. I am at the very tail end of the lead-out train, and as the sweeper, it's my job to deal with all of those people who are fighting for the end of our train. Like, if you look in the rear camera right now, it is just a constant shuffle of chaos, of riders who want to get behind us, who are surging, who are battling for that wheel. So it's my job to make sure that Sam doesn't deal with that. He is just doing a constant effort focused on one thing and one thing only, and that is following the rider in front of him. Meanwhile, I am just bumping and battling with this Ride Bikes Bro guy on my left. I don't know exactly what he's trying to accomplish here, but he was super aggressive with over 3 kilometers to go, and I'm not going to lose Sam's wheel. But I guess this is my point, is I am dealing with this stuff so that Sam doesn't have to. And there's other benefits to having a sweeper in your lead-out train, too. If you think about it, say we get our timing just right, Sam gets dropped off at 200 meters to go. We're going 40 miles an hour. Now the sprinters behind, they will have to come around me and then come around Sam in order to take the win. So that's one extra bike length, which is huge, by the way, when you're going 40 plus miles an hour. But say we get the timing totally wrong and Sam accidentally gets dropped off with like 350, 400 meters to go. Well, I'd say the last benefit for a sweeper is I'm kind of the insurance policy. So I'll be ready to go just in case we get that timing totally wrong. We'll still have a sprinter to contest the win. So one thing we could have done a lot better, and I'm reminded of it right now because we're on this final straightaway before the final right-hander, is our position as a lead out. So take a look at that wind direction. It's a straight left to right crosswind through here. And I forgot how close I got to Sam right there. I think I hit his rear derailleur with my wheel. That was super close. But like I was saying, we should not have allowed all of these riders to squeeze up the inside, the sheltered side on us. We should have really protected that inside, and we should have been riding closer to the gutter. And that would have prevented all these riders from sliding up the inside. And again, like, as the sweeper, it's my job to deal with that, but it would have been much easier. We would have had a much easier time if we rode closer to the gutter, especially on that last crosswind section. And that's particularly important on the last lap. I want you guys to pay attention to that on the last lap. So speaking of one lap to go, I fast forward a little bit. We're approaching one lap to go, and now we're starting to lose riders. This is Dylan on the right. So Dylan, total stud, covered basically every early move attack, still had the energy to bring us up to 31 miles an hour with 1,600 meters left. And this is all according to plan. We're going to keep at a really high rate of speed here. And what I'm going to do is, you heard me right there, I'm going to start yelling at my teammates in kind of an obnoxious amount of yelling. And that's because I am the only one who's got eyeballs on what's going on back here. Everyone else in the lead out, still yelling. They are focused on taking their poles, and they're focused on their efforts. It's my job to make sure that they know, because I'm the only one who can sense what's going on back here, they know what rate of speed that they need to go. And I am seeing these riders attack. That was one of the Ride Bikes bros getting to the front. I'm not sure why. This actually helps us. He was acting almost like another Mike Spikes lead out. He just brought us up to 36 miles an hour. I had a rider on my right who was contesting Sam's wheel, so it's getting a little bit dicey right here. I think that was one of the most critical moments of the race, is not letting that wheel go and fighting for Sam's rear wheel, because my sweeper duties aren't done yet. So that Ride Bikes bro just finished and took a pull off on the right. You saw him. Now it's, I think that's Chaz on the left for Ride Bikes bro, and now he's going to take over where his teammate left off. And maybe Chaz thinks he's got his teammates behind him. I'm not exactly sure. But Mike Spikes has total control at this point. Into this headwind, you have Brennan on the front doing all, I don't know how many watts, all of the watts, guys. 33 miles an hour into a strong, straight headwind, which is insane. We have four riders still. Like, we went so fast in this final lap, we set a course record. This is a race course that has been going on for a decade. I don't know how many hundreds of races have been on it. And we set a course record today. That's how fast we're going on this final lap. And here we go. I'm still quarterbacking this thing. We have Miles hitting the front now into this crosswind because we're not going fast enough. And now we need to go 37 miles an hour. I'm going to yell at Sam in just a second here because, look, guys, remember, 200 meters to go. Look at the timing here. Doesn't get much better than this. I'm sweeper, so I'm going to navigate this corner much more poorly than Sam does. Sam takes a great line. I look back right about here under my shoulder. I realize, oh, we're clear. I may as well sprint for second. So that's exactly what I do. Sam's just got it by a country mile. Super stoked to go 1-2 with the team. But there's always room for improvement. And I just want to talk about that final straightaway, especially on the last lap before the final corner. We really should have been further to the right and prevented anybody from coming up the inside, the sheltered side of that final straightaway. Which is like tearing a page out of the Legion of LA playbook. You start on the inside, you swing out wide before taking that final corner. The one really good thing we did do is what you can see Miles doing, which is peeling, making his final pull and peeling off to the right to block that inside line. So it's hard to complain when you go 1-2, but you know, when we got together after the race as a team, that's what we talked about as the key takeaway and something that we can improve upon for next time. So anyway, thanks for watching, guys, and I will catch you at the next one.